I'm Amanda Olson from IntimateRose.com, and I'm a doctor of physical therapy and certified pelvic floor rehabilitation specialist. And today I want to talk about how vaginal weights aren't just for endurance. So in a lot of the literature, in a lot of the research, there are various protocols that have compared using vaginal weights to nothing at all, no treatment at all, or to regular pelvic floor muscle training, which is very rarely clearly defined, but in some cases is. But they have found in some instances vaginal weights to be effective in the treatment of overactive bladder syndrome, and also in strengthening the pelvic floor for urinary incontinence and pelvic floor muscle strength for pelvic organ prolapse. So one of the things that is important to keep in mind is that some of the protocols for using the weights vary between 15 and 20 minutes, and some of them use one session per day versus two sessions per day. And certainly vaginal weights are not for every patient. They are not for everyone. But for some patients, it can be highly effective in helping to strengthen their pelvic floor. They can be more adherent because, especially in the Intimate Rose Kegel set, they are able to track their progress as they get stronger, and that can be very motivating for them. So the color white is 25 grams. As the color pink or purple gets darker, the weight gets heavier. And considering too the principles of exercise training that we follow in other aspects of strengthening our muscles, of adding a resistance band to get stronger, the vaginal weights make perfect sense in that regard. And certainly we're teaching our patients how to do a proper contract and a proper relax. And in the endurance protocols of having them, say, put it in and take a shower, they're getting a really nice variety of movement. You know, they're washing their hair and getting some extension, they're bending over and washing their feet, getting a variety of movements. The pelvic floor is contracting and relaxing in those instances. And 10 to 15 minutes or 15 to 20 minutes has shown no adverse reactions in those research participants. And then lately, there's been an insurgence of using the Kegel weights for training athletes or athletic females, especially after childbirth, to strengthen the pelvic floor and be able to return to sport. And what some of the protocols are showing is that putting the Kegel weight in and having them do functional movements is helping to train them to be able to contract and hold while they're doing that functional movement. And then they can relax, you know, 10 to 12 repetitions, three sets, just like we would in any other strengthening protocol. But one of the areas that I have found to be a great benefit to my patients, and I'm seeing it across to other clinicians as well, is the key and primary reason why Kegel weights were invented, and that's for proprioceptive training. So Kegel weights or vaginal cones, as they're referred to in the literature, were invented in the 1980s, and they were intended to be a proprioceptive input tool. So the very nature of having something in the vagina helps the patient to locate the pelvic floor and to be able to contract and lift appropriately, because if they bear down, it's going to come out of their body. So one of the ways that you can train even very, very low tone, poor proprioceptive patients that are having a difficult time finding their pelvic floor muscles, you know, maybe you're educating them in a contract and lift and using biofeedback in clinic, and then they go home and they come back and they say, I'm not sure if I'm doing them right. And this goes on and on and on for weeks, whereas they're doing great in clinic, but as soon as they are away from those clinical tools, they have lost their ability to find their pelvic floor muscles. So what I do in this case is I have the patient start with the white weight, which is 25 grams, and I'll put them into quadruped position. So here's the pelvic floor. Here they are in quadruped, so they're going to put the white Kegel weight into the vagina here. And what it's going to do is, in that quadruped position, it's going to lean forward onto the anterior fibers of the pelvic floor because they are in this quadruped position. That's going to put pressure most oftentimes, especially with patients that are experiencing urinary incontinence. That's exactly where we want them to be contracting anyways. And so what they are feeling is that pressure on the anterior fibers, and then we can guide them to be contracting and lifting and pulling it further into the body and then relaxing in that quadruped position. You can also have them lay in side lying here And it's going to tip into, so say if they are in left side lying, the vaginal weight is going to tip slightly onto the left aspect of the pelvic floor, and they can be practicing in a non-gravity position. So they're not working against gravity. So they're not fighting against the weight, because oftentimes they are very, very weak, but they are still getting that input, and they can strengthen there, and then you can have them roll over into right side lying. It's gonna tip into the right aspect of the pelvic floor muscles, and they're practicing contracting and pulling it in. You can even have them in supine, and clinically, if they're in clinic with you, if they're lying in supine, you can gently pull on the tail of the Kegel weight a little bit and have them feel that and have them resist it. And oftentimes that little bit of input is enough for their brain to catch it and to be able to resist it and contract. Because they're in a non-gravity working against position, you could also use a little bit of a heavier weight if they are really poor proprioception, or maybe they're post-op and they had some swelling in the area and we're trying to revitalize those nerves and help them find the pelvic floor muscles. You could even use a little bit heavier one. As they get stronger, as their proprioceptive capabilities get better, they can progress up. You can have them put the weight in seated position. So they're still getting some nice input from the seat below them, and then the vaginal weight is in the vagina, and now they are working against gravity, but they have that little bit of added support from the seat and a little bit of more diffuse proprioceptive input through the gluteal muscles from sitting, and have them do an active contract, hold for 3 to 5 seconds, and relax. And they can do their repetition of Kegels in that position. In that way, you can help to progress some of those low tone patients a little bit quicker, because they are, one, certain they're doing it correctly, because if they have their set, they can go home and they have it, and if it's falling out, they know for certain that they're doing it wrong, and it's instant biofeedback for them to then pull up and in the opposite direction. So, vaginal weights as a proprioceptive tool, even in patients that are very, very weak, in addition to the other strengthening protocols and endurance protocols that we've seen. For more information, don't hesitate to reach out. You can email us at support@intimaterose.com.